In 1964, when I arrived in New York, searching for a place for me in the American theater to create, to share, the Tony Honors was a distant dream. Both the Tony Awards and the theater meant much, much more to me than a place where great artists, really American artists, writers, wrote for the theater. I wanted to integrate African Americans and women into the American theater. I met and actually talked to people like Paul Robeson, Fred O'Neill, Robert Penn Warren, Robert Lowell, Ralph Ellison, Langston Hughes, Tennessee Williams. I worked with Roscoe Lee Brown, Lloyd Richards, Robert Earl Jones, Willa Kim, Kurt Lundell, the great Frank Langella, watched the beginning of careers, Faye Dunaway, Dustin Hoffman, Glenn Turman, Chadwick Boseman, Amiri Baraka. I was shaped as a producer by my relationship with American black playwrights. Ed Bullins, Ron Milner, Charles Fuller, Elaine Jackson, Lawrence Holder, Lonnie Elder III, Jim DeJong, Ntozake Shange. For me, it was an oasis, a light. You know, when darkness began to settle in around you, a friend can be detected by the light that he carries. Thank you, Tony. Thank you. I salute you. In recognition of a groundbreaking theater that has been training artists and producing plays by people of color and women, as well as developing multicultural audiences for more than 50 years. Wow.